Putting your Zoom room together is the easy part. Remember, the computer is the brains, so everything is going to connect to the brains of the room. First, be sure to plug in the power cord and connect to the internet. Although you can use a wireless connection, a wired connection is recommended. Then, plug in your displays and connect them to power and your computer. In this example, we are going to have just one display plugged into the computer's HDMI port. Depending on the computer selected, you can have up to three displays connected in the room. Now, connect your external webcam to the computer. This will go into an available USB port. You want to position the webcam so that it is generally just below the display. This will make it so that the camera is near eye level for those seated in the room and allows for virtual eye contact. For your audio, plug in the microphone and speakers. How these devices connect will depend on which devices you have chosen. They can be USB or even Bluetooth. In this room, we are going to use a USB microphone, the MXL AC404, and a Yamaha ESB 1080 soundbar, which will connect via Bluetooth. Remember, as long as the computer recognizes it, so can Zoom. Though you can use your computer's built-in speaker and microphone, external options typically provide the best experience. Lastly, an appliance is an optional device that has speakers, a microphone, and camera or other peripherals built into one device. We won't be using one in this setup, but feel free to explore this option for your room. That's it! Your Zoom room is now connected and ready to power on. Pair the controller to the room and start using your Zoom room to launch instant meetings, start scheduled meetings, share content wirelessly, and more.